Okay, Vijay. So let's start with the halogenation now. Now we are doing the halogenation reaction with the chloromethane reaction with the chlorine now. In the presence of the anhydrous iron chloride, right? FeCl3. Now what happens now? If we just see clearly, we already saw that the formation of the bond can be easily possible at the ortho and the para position because of the electron cloud is more there, isn't it?
Yes.
Now the electrophilic substitution reaction can happen there now. Electrophilic substitution attacks at the ortho and para position. So now we form the 1,4-dichlorobenzene and another forms the 1,2-dichlorobenzene. Correct. So the possibility of two products happens now. Right? Because since it's a symmetric, so where from wherever you count it will be 1,2 only. And from wherever it will come, it will be 1,2,3,4 only, right? 1,4-dichlorobenzene and 1,2-dichlorobenzene. So 1,2-dichlorobenzene is the minor product and major product is 80% of the product will be para positions, right? And the minor product will be 1,2-dichlorobenzene. So that's what we're saying is that ring gets sophisticated, you know, ring gets somewhat deactivated as compared to the benzene, and hence electrophilic substitution reactions occurs in the haloarenes slowly and sometimes requires the drastic conditions. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Right now for the nitration reaction, here we are going to treat with the nitric acid now. Same haloarenes. Now we're going to treat with the nitric acid. Okay. Now write on this part nitric acid one.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
Now same thing chlorobenzene. We're taking the chlorobenzene example. Now we'll treat with the nitric acid in the presence of the concentrated sulfuric acid.
Okay.
Now again, see nitric acid, we are going to form the again. So here we have the electrophile is what? You know, nitro group is again the you have an electrophile here, right? Now same things. The reaction will happen again. Nitro groups is going to react, going to attack the ortho and the para positions, right? Because that's where the place where the electron density is higher, correct? Now nitro groups attacks the ortho position and forms the 1,2-nitrobenzene, and the para position becomes the 1,4-nitrobenzene, right? So again the para position becomes the major product, and then you have the minor product is 1,2-nitrobenzene. Clear?
Yes.
Good. Now write down for the sulfonation reaction now. Write down for the sulfonation reaction.
Okay,
no? Okay.
Yeah.
So sulfonic acid. We need to find the sulfonic acid. Now sulfonic acid can be easily, you know, come from the sulfuric acid reaction, because when you try to treat with the haloarenes, so finally it has to form the benzene sulfonic acid. It becomes a sulfonic acid. Sulfonic acid nothing but the HSO3 is the combination. Here the electrophile is nothing but HSO3, right? Because H2SO4 splits into the H plus ions and the HSO3 ions. Correct. So now, since there is again the electrophilic substitution reaction, so it will attack the ortho and the para position. So again, the minor product will be, here the IUPAC name is pretty important because 2-chlorobenzene-sulfonic acid we say, right? And 4-chlorobenzene-sulfonic acid we say, right? 2-chloro, because it's at the same place, because benzene, when we talk about the benzene-sulfonic acid, we are treating the sulfonic acid as a parent compound, right? So benzene-sulfonic acid, yeah, we are taking as a parent chain. So considering the reference point of the HSO3, when you count from the left hand side or right hand side, chlorine comes to the one, you know, second position, and then in the other product the chlorine comes in the fourth position, so it becomes the 2-chloro and then 4-chloro. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, understood.
Okay, now very important reaction, we are going for the Fiddle-Crafts reactor now. Fiddle-Crafts reaction, what is that reaction? Okay, Fiddle-Crafts reaction is basically to obtain the, you know, the 1-chloro-2-methyl-benzene, or basically you can just say, you know, the 2-chloro-toluene. Okay, because CH3 is, you know, CH3 connected to the benzene ring is called the toluene group also, you know? So it becomes the, you know, chloro-toluene, right? So you can have 2-chlorotoluene and the 4-chlorotoluene. So how does it forms now? Still now we want the electrophile now here to be the methyl group now, because see, all these we are talking about the electron withdrawing groups only, isn't it? Because all the electrophilic substitution reactions, so whatever we discussed, if we just see here the halogenation, again the chlorine is the electron, you know, highly electronegative, that means electron withdrawing groups. Nitric acid, again very high oxidizing agent, so nitro group comes, nitro group is again the electron withdrawing group. HSO3-sulfonic acid, again it's the same thing. Now comes to the alkyl halides. Alkyl halides, we always talk about the alkyl halides, remember that, whether it is a primary alkyl halide 1 degree 2 degree or 3 degree, we always talked about the electron withdrawing groups as the alkyl group, isn't it? So
yeah,
when the haloarenes are treated with the methyl chloride, and so just write down the Fiddle-Crafts reaction, then I'll explain to you how does this reaction occurs. Okay, just write down this reaction, Fiddle-Crafts reaction, because this is extremely important reaction.
Thank you. Okay.
Now, so remember the catalyst, we use anhydrous aluminium chloride, you know, and then in this reaction, Fiddle-Crafts reaction is to make the benzene connected with the alkyl group. So you have the haloarenes. Now you will make the reaction with the methyl chloride. So here is the haloarene, and this is the haloalkane. Can you see that? Haloarene reaction with the haloalkanes. So what happens now? Electrophile is nothing but the CH3 here. CH3 becomes electrophile here. Now electrophile attacks, you know, the electrophile is going to attack the ortho or the para position only, right? So CH3 gets attacked, you know, it attacks the carbon at the ortho position and carbon at the para position. Again the same thing, there is no change in the positions, so it forms the 1-chloro-2-methyl-benzene, so it's a IUPAC name. Second thing, 1-chloro-4-methyl is the benzene, is the next IUPAC name. So major product is the para position one, so mention that part. Clear?
Yes,
Fiddle-Crafts reaction, remember that Fiddle-Crafts reaction is always with the alkyl halide. You want to treat the haloarenes with the alkyl halide or the haloalkanes. So this is how you have to remember that haloalkanes plus haloarenes, that is nothing but the Fiddle-Crafts reaction.
Okay.
Got it, no? Your chapter says it's
Yes,
also
sir.
haloalkanes, halovarenes. So that itself tells you about the Friedel-Crafts reaction. So that's why how the Friedel-Crafts reaction is important. Clear? Any
Yes, sir.
questions, any doubts? Yeah.
No, sir. Clear.
Okay, so let's go to the next reaction. Yeah, let's go to the acetyl chloride reaction now. Next reaction, write down Ujai, with the haloarenes reaction with the acetyl chloride. What will form? Let's try to understand this part. Okay, write down the reaction, then I'll tell you what happens here. So you have the haloarene reaction with the CH3COCl. So what happens now? CH3CO. See, CH3CO is a acetone group, right? CH3O, CH3CO hold twice O, that becomes an acetone. Now we have the, let's say, acetic acid CH3COOH. When you replace the OH with the Cl, what it becomes? CH3COCl, right? So it CH3CO is, anyway, it's acetyl group. So acetyl chloride. When you reaction with acetyl chlorides, so what happens now? So here the electrophile becomes the CH3CO. So the carbon atom, which is, which is connected to the CCl, that gets broken, and then CH3CO. So here, if we just see the alkyl, the electron withdrawing groups are, the methyl group and the oxygen for the carbon atom, which is present in the, which is at the central carbon atom. Now this electrophile attacks the ortho and the para position. Now clear? So bond is pretty simple only, right? Bond is the CCl bond gets has to get broken from the acetyl chloride, isn't it? Now CH3CO is there. It'll attack from the carbon side, this part, right? So which is connected to the oxygen atom. So it forms the bond with the ortho position and forms bond with the para position, right? Now what is the product gets formed? What is the product name, say? So CCl and CCO, CH3CO. So basically CH3CO with the benzene ring is called the acetophenone. So
okay,
when you remove the Cl part from here, okay, so when you remove the Cl part from here, so the compound which gets formed is nothing but this compound itself is called the acetophenone. Because when you remove the Cl part from here, so what it becomes? It becomes a CH3CO, isn't it? And the phenyl is connected to this part, so it becomes acetophenone. Correct? And so it becomes a parent group now. Acetophenone is again becomes a parent group, and the chlorine is connected to the second carbon atom, considering the fixed position of the aceto group on the top, and then becomes a 2-chloroacetophenol. Correct? And similarly you have the 4-chloroacetophenol. Clear? Any questions, any doubts? And again the major product is this only, right? So Friedel-Crafts reaction is basically, in the presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride, you react with either with acetyl chloride or with the alkyl halide. So you'll get the two products. The major product will be always the para position one. Clear?
Yes,
sir. Any questions, any doubts, Vijay? Understood, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go to the. Although the chlorine is an electron withdrawing group, yet it's also para directing in the electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions. Why? Let's see that part now. You know, what happens in the electrophilic substitution reaction? Attack in the ortho position and attack in the para positions. Now, let's say you can just answer this question very easily, because although chlorine is electron withdrawing group, yet it is ortho para directing in the electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions. Why?
Okay.
What, Vijay?
No, I got it.
You got it?
Yeah.
Excellent. So, can you explain me how this happens?
The example, right?
Yeah, example only. Just explain the example so that.
Oh, example adding it. I was talking about the previous one.
Ajay, previous one. Okay, got it. Previous one, got it. Okay,
yeah.
Now no problem. Can you just quickly draw this the electron destabilization structure? Then I'll explain to you. You know, because you need to understand the diagram clearly from here. Then I'll explain to you this diagram. Okay, draw this first diagram. So just need to understand why the destabilization happens here. Okay. Done. Okay,
yeah.
Good, excellent. See, basically our question is very simple. Why the we say the electron is a, you know, the chlorine is the electron withdrawing group, right? And then still we say the chlorine, because of that, why it is directing the ortho and para position for the electrophilic substitution, right? So when any electron withdrawing group comes, let's say in a electrophilic electrophile comes and have the reaction with the halogen. So what role the chlorine plays there? So in this reaction, if you see, the chlorine is electron withdrawing group, and because of the high electronegativity, it actually, you know, takes the electron towards itself. You know, it looks like the carbon is giving the electron to the chlorine. So carbon at the chlorine side slightly develops a positive charge, isn't it? And then, then what happens? Slight positive charge. Then the bond gets broken between the carbon at the ortho position and the carbon at the CCl bond. Correct? Now the carbon at the ortho position develops a slight negative charge. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So carbon at the ortho position, we already seen how the carbon getting the negative charge at the ortho position, isn't it? Because of the double bond breaking. So once it becomes so negative charge comes at the carbon at the ortho position. So what happens? The electrophile is the positive, you know, charge. So because it is electron loving, so it attacks the carbon at the ortho position, and so it starts forming the bond with the ortho position one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Now what happens? What is the inductive effect now? Chlorine, because withdraws the electrons through the inductive effect and releases electrons through the resonance. So inductive effect is nothing but the through induction, you know.
Okay.
It attracts the electrons towards the itself, right? And then the slight positive charge comes, and then the through the resonance anyway, we have seen that the electrons, the negative charge is circulating, right?
Yes.
Now, and because of this, we can say the chlorine is destabilizing the intermediate carbocation. Right? It destabilizes the intermediate carbocation. So what is intermediate carbocations? Because the slight positive charge is there, and then you have the negative charge on the other carbon atom. So basically the electrophile is coming and attacking the ortho position. Right? Excellent. Now, what happens now? The two positions are there. Now, we know negative charge can come to the ortho position, negative charge can come to the para position. That's why two reactions you can see that. The electrophile is putting at the forming the bond at the ortho and the para position, right? And there is a slight positive charge coming at the carbon at the CX bond, right?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, because of the what exactly happened? Resonance is anyway happening now, and because of the halogen present at the topmost carbon, tends to stabilize the carbocation. When it tries to stabilize the carbocation, the effect is more pronounced at the ortho and the para positions only. Inductive effect is stronger than the resonance and hence causes non-electron withdrawn and hence causes the net deactivations. So what happens now? Because the effect is more pronounced. So that effect we have seen that the ortho and para position effect is very strong. But the inductive effect is stronger than the resonance. What it means inductive is effect strong. Inductive effect means the carbon, the CX bond which is connected, C and the CaCl bond, you know, carbon at the chlorine bond. The carbon develops a slight positive charge because of the inductive effect, and then this is more stronger than compared to the resonance.
Okay.
Got it? So this bond is very strong. This, you know, this phenomenon is very strong than compared to the resonance, the circulation of the negative charge. And this resonance effect tends to oppose the inductive effect. Because of resonance, what is happening? Resonance is actually trying to stabilize the inductive effect. But inductive effect tries to destabilize the resonance. Got it?
Yes, sir.
So the more stronger the inductive effect at the CCl bond, the more stronger the resonance effect will happen only at the ortho and the para positions. Because from there only the negative charge is circulating. So that becomes an electrophile for you. That is a place for the electrophilic attack. Got it, no? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Understood. Any questions, any doubts, Jai?
No, sir. Clear.
Okay. Fine, Vijay. Chala, I think let's close it right now here. Only little small amount is, small portions are remaining here. We'll try to finish this part. Okay. These are now all the Wurtz fitting and the Fittig's reactions. These are pretty simple reactions. We'll cover in the next class then. I think next class we should be able to finish this chapter then.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Just revise it in case still you have any confusion. We can discuss then.
Okay.
Okay? Sure. Okay. Fine, Vijay. Sure. Okay. Bye.